I want to install this window air conditioning unit in this window. Problem is, this is a casement window. It opens up far enough that it would actually fit in there, but then it'd be sticking way out and there's no way to close the top of the window. So I want to take this window panel out altogether and make a smaller window panel to go above the AC unit right there. When ripping through a 2x4, I often end up having it pinch on the blade, so this time I had the idea of first making a cut at about 3/4 depth, then going back to the start and doing a plunge cut near the start, cutting to the end, and after that, cut that little bit near the start, and that way it didn't pinch the blade on me. After that, cutting the pieces to length on a table saw, straightening them on a jointer, and then through the thickness planer for consistent sizing. And joining the ends with box joints, because that's what I do, because I have a box joint jig. Making sure the fit is good, and then I'm ready to cut the rest of the pieces. Now cutting a rabbet along the pieces to fit the glass into. And now I need to trim a little bit off the ends because the inside most part of it is actually going to be a miter joint, and I finished that on the bandsaw. These fit together like this. I still got to chisel that out a little bit, but I'll glue it together first. Then I realized I should have cut those rabbets deeper, so I set up this jig on the router table, which allowed me to get into the corners. And I should have used that in the first place because there's very little in the corner there that still needs chiseling out from cutting it deeper. I've got this old storm window to use for the glass, but it's not big enough. And I didn't want to make the frame super wide. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put it in this way and then cover that area with plywood. I made this thing here that'll be the divider between the glass and the plywood. I don't like cutting glass very much because if at first you don't succeed, you're screwed. Now for the glass panel, I don't want to be hammering right next to it, so I've drilled pilot holes for screws to go in like this, but I'll leave the glass panel out until I fit this whole window in the frame. I still have this stud sticking out a bit, so I'm going to use part of the packaging to use as a pad for the sill. It's heavy, but it's not too bad of a lift from the front. Not good. So my top panel doesn't fit, and it doesn't fit by almost exactly the thickness of this shim here, so I have to get rid of that. I think this cardboard shim will do, because it doesn't actually stick up by that much. That fits now. Originally I was going to put the plywood on the bottom, but I think it looks better this way. Easier to look out the window that way. Now I just have to cut out a whole bunch of little notches and such to fit around some of the hardware. This little slot and plate engages the existing window lock mechanism to hold this panel in place. This air conditioner comes with these side things for closing the rest of the window, but the way I've got everything, I can't even use those. So instead, I've got this piece of plywood cut exactly the size. Fits like this. Then this goes on top of the air conditioner. And then I've got these clips to hold it in place. And after about 25 trips to the shop making various trims, this top panel now fits. And now it's installed, but man, getting that window fit took forever. I think a professional could install a whole mini split in less time than I spent on that. Of course, the install would have been positively straightforward if I put it in a vertical slider window, but we don't have one of those. Although I realize now it would have fit in this window here if I take the side panels off, because the whole unit itself is only 21 inches wide. And this window AC unit was sent to me by Drio. They seem to have a lot of confidence in our products, at least enough to let me mess with them. And this one is supposed to be quite efficient. And tomorrow's gonna be a hot day, so I'm gonna put some space heaters in here and see how much heat this thing can suck out of this room. And that will be in an upcoming video.